Hey guys, Joe from the Crazy New York Driver Show. Today is Friday, December 7th, 2012. And we have a lot to discuss. Today's topics are going to be PayPal and eBay, your two favorite topics. It is cold out, it's raining, it's just freaking depressing. And the reason I'm filming this video outside is because I wanted to get it in the can before I leave for work. Because once I get to work, I have a lot to do and I won't have time. All right, let's get started. Let's firstly start out by doing a recap about last week's video. Last week I did the video where I told you guys I'm taking PayPal on my eBay Motors account. I explained my situation and I asked for your opinion. I knew I'd get a lot of comments, but I was surprised, and positively surprised, by the support you guys showed me, and I thank you for it. I dare say 99% of you guys applauded my decision and told me you approved of it and that I did the right thing. Now, naturally, there were some people that disapproved, and they're entitled to their opinion. But what I found interesting was all the people that disapproved also followed up with a codicil, which stated something like, "Well, Joe, I don't take PayPal, and I don't think you should take it either, but I no longer sell on eBay." Yet, everyone who does sell on eBay, which is most of you guys, all you guys who sell on eBay do take PayPal. My question is there anyone out there who sells on eBay and does not take PayPal? Now, for the longest time, that was me. My question is, do any of you sell on eBay and not take PayPal? I don't think there's a single one of you. But if there is, I want to comment below who you are. I want to research that because, you know, that's your business. More about PayPal. I have now been a PayPal member for 2 weeks, and I'd like to give you an update. Since I signed up for PayPal, I have done 44 transactions. How does it break down? Out of those 44 transactions, 41 of them paid with PayPal. Zero paid with ProPay, not one. And I had two unpaid item cases. Really, it should be one. And I'm going to explain that to you in a second, once we segue over to the eBay section of the video. Because as I told you last week, as far as PayPal is concerned, that company has evolved. And I've been speaking to some of the people at PayPal over the last 2 weeks, one-on-one. And not through email either. That's one thing about them. I will say it. People at PayPal have reached out to me. They've listened to me. They're concerned about the same things I'm concerned about and that you're concerned about, which is scammers and ripoffs. And they have expressed an interest to work with us, and that's great. So I urge you guys, if you ever have any problems with PayPal, if somebody scams you, report it to the PayPal Fraud Division. They will listen. One thing they do need to do, and I have talked to some people at PayPal about this, they need to get the word out that they are not the PayPal of 10 years ago. This is the new PayPal. All right? I would even like to see them put some kind of a little logo, change their logo or their tagline or something to say the new PayPal or PayPal 2013 or seller friendly PayPal. PayPal, the seller's friend. Come on, guys. Think of some kind of catchy icon or catchy slogan, because it's important to get the word out that you guys are going to back sellers up against fraudulent claims. Now, I'm not talking about legit chargebacks, because there are some sellers that, you know, will sell bogus goods. And that's something I want to address maybe next week. I'm making a list of eBay sellers who are selling fraudulent goods. I hate that. But as far as PayPal is concerned, I've been with them for 2 weeks. I've had no problems, no complaints. They've reached out to me several times on the telephone, and we're still in contact with each other. The site is easy to use. And as many of you had said, I can now offer immediate payment option to decrease the deadbeat bidders. But the one thing I didn't realize, in order to use immediate payment, you can only offer PayPal. You cannot offer ProPay as well. It's PayPal and that's it. Okay? So that's basically my update on PayPal. Everything's good, no complaints. And yeah, there was one interesting comment. I had a few naysayer comments last week. And one interesting comment that I really liked, one of the best of the naysayers, he said, "Joe, ever since you came back from eBay on location, you seem to be in a different frame of mind." And that guy was correct. I can't impress upon you guys enough how important it is to deal with people on a one-to-one basis in person. It makes all the difference in the world. If you have a problem on eBay and they route you to the Philippines, it ain't gonna work. I'm telling you, it ain't gonna work. All right? If you have a problem on eBay and they route you to Utah, well, that's better. That's a lot better. And it will help. In many cases, it will help the problem totally. But it's always better one-on-one to look at someone, talk to them, express your concerns, and in some cases, show them what your concerns are. When I went to eBay on location, I went online with them and I showed them certain accounts, including that guy that we've talked about so many times, Delta1784. And these guys were really at a loss. It's like, you know, they were shocked. But they were receptive, and I'm glad I went, and if I can ever go again, I will. And I urge you guys, if eBay on location comes in your area, go to it. You'll meet the important people from eBay, PayPal, PayPal Fraud Division, eBay Trust and Safety. But my complaint with eBay, my current complaint, and it's ongoing, is they're not doing enough to police deadbeat bidders. Now, somebody wrote to me the other day and told me they started a new eBay account and they bid on a few items, let's say three. They paid for the first two and the third one they didn't pay for. Now, they didn't give a reason why they didn't, but they didn't pay. And they claimed that eBay froze their account and said, "You are not permitted to bid on any more items for a duration of, I think it was 1 week or 1 month, I'm not sure." But eBay, you gotta tighten up your act. Now, I know for a fact that the guys from eBay and PayPal are watching these videos, and I welcome them. I'm glad to have them, because if this is what it takes to make it a better trading environment, I'm all for it. I'm going to show you an ironclad case right now, what someone did to me. What I want from you guys is I want your opinion of why, what possible reason this guy could have done this, considering I take PayPal. About 2 weeks ago, right when I made, right before I made my last video, a guy with zero feedback bid on, well, he didn't bid on it. He did a buy it now on a Mazda hubcap from the year 1990, which is a very obscure car. How many 1990 Mazdas are there? His screen name is Neidasez. All right, he's out of Massachusetts. After he does the buy it now, he navigates away from the pay page and disappears. As soon as I saw that, I blocked him. He's done. I knew I'd never see any money off this clown. I figured it was over. The next day, the same exact person out of Massachusetts starts a brand new eBay account with this name, A D E N Y 1990. He now has a 2 next to his name, but I'll explain that in a second. He also does the buy it now on the same item, navigates away, never hear from him. I block him. After 4 days, each one of these guys gets their unpaid item notice. I open a case against them both, and none of them ever pay. What the guy does is he bids on a third item, the same item from another seller, for more money than I'm charging. My item was $39.95 with free shipping. The other guy's item was $27.16.43 shipping for a total of $43.43. Why? Can anyone please hypothesize for me why a screwball like this would bid on my first item, not pay, create a second account, bid on my second item, not pay, then bid on the same item from another eBayer for more money and pay him? Now, it's not PayPal, because I take PayPal. And it's not because the other guy's item was any better. If anything, it was probably not as good, because mine was an actual photo of the item, where the other guy is using a scanned file picture from the Hollander Interchange Manual, and it clearly says across the picture, property of Hollander. So eBay, this is for you guys at eBay, trust and safety. How is this possible? That this guy can create 2 accounts. You say you link the accounts when they log on from the same site. The guy's out of Massachusetts, all right? You can see that he bid on the same item from another seller. At the very least, he should be suspended, all right? And I don't even want to get into a question of how another seller can scan in a picture from the Holland Interchange Manual. It's not even the actual picture. We're getting into intellectual property there. And there goes a plane overhead. I'm on the direct flight path to JFK. So planes going overhead are very, very common. I don't even notice them. So that's where I'm at this week, folks. I'm out here in the cold rain, and I'm going to get inside and upload this video. So, I would like comments from you guys below. The comments, please keep them topical. What do you think about PayPal? Is it better than it used to be? I say it is. A lot better. I take it, and I'm happy. Period. What about eBay? Are your sales up or down? Do you still have problems with deadbeat bidders? Alright? Let's address that. And lastly, as far as next week's video, I'm going to do a lot more about eBay and ProPay. And then the week after, I'm going to do my special year-end video, which is going to be really something big this year. I got something great planned. I'll explain that to you next week. But for right now, I'm Crazy New York Driver, and you're not. Thanks for watching. And comment below.